we're back. Me and Millie, the snoring pocket bully, subliminal. She's literally laying right there. I'm looking at her. We're back with another video. If you are new here, my name is Sammy and we are the Mermaid Gang. This is where you can come and suspend your disbelief. I am your favorite manifestation coach and your favorite YouTuber. So if you would like for me to help you dissolve whatever is between you and your manifestation, go ahead and sign up for coaching with me below. There is a sale going right now until the end of December. No code needed. It's already marked down. Oh, also, again, for people who want to do phone calls, book my mom. She's down below in my description. I don't do phone calls, but she does phone calls and she loves phone calls. So if you like phone coaching, she's your lady. She loves that shit. So, yeah. Okay. No, I didn't even mention my Krampus shirt in the last video. I'm about to film a paranormal video about Krampus and another Christmas demon. So, you know, head over to my second channel if you are interested in that. It's probably up by now, actually. Yeah, probably. Okay. So, I want to talk about being delusional because people have literally commented that before. They're like, so you want me to just be delusional? Yeah. That's what I mean when I say not wavering. I mean be fucking delusional. I mean that when you're manifesting $100,000 in your bank account and you look at your bank account and it says 500, I want you to look at that bank and go, look at that. I always have six figures in the bank. I have $100,000 in the bank. Or whenever you're manifesting your SP and they're like, I hate you, stop texting me, or you're just flat out blocked, I want you to look at that phone and go, oh my God, he will not stop texting me. He's so freaking obsessed with me. Jesus Christ, he's obsessed with me. He will not stop texting me. He is so in love with me. He is constantly telling me how he is so in love with me. She will not leave me alone. She is so obsessed with me. Jeez, she's always texting me. That's what I mean. I want you to be delusional. When you see that exam grade and you're like, oh my God, you're about to say, I can't believe I failed. You go, I passed that shit with flying colors. That was so easy. That was the easiest exam ever. I literally got a perfect score. That was so easy. Or you see a denial letter from a college that you want to go to and you're like, oh my God, I got in. I got in. Look at this. This is my congratulations acceptance letter. Look at my congratulation. Look at my acceptance letter. I got in. I got into my dream school. Or you're manifesting perfect skin and you look at yourself in the mirror and you see a horrible breakout and you go, oh my God, my skin looks so good. Oh my God, my skin's like glass. It's literally perfect. My skin is flawless. I look so good. Or you're manifesting weight loss and you look in the mirror and you go, oh my God, I'm literally so skinny. Like, look how, I'm so freaking skinny. Or you want a bigger butt. You're like, oh my God, my ass is so fat. I have the fattest ass in the world. Or you manifested bigger boobs. My boobs are freaking huge. I literally look like I got a boob job. Yeah, I want you to be delusional. Delusional. You're manifesting a brand new mansion and you're walking around your apartment going, yep, my house is almost ready for me. I just bought a mansion. I just bought a 10 bedroom house. Whatever it is, I want you to be delusional. And the reason why I say this is because your subconscious has no eyes. It has no eyes. You're the messenger to your subconscious. It only knows what you tell it. And your subconscious is a proof producing machine. Therefore, whatever message you're sending it, whatever paper you're laying on the copier is what it's gonna spit out. So what do you want it to spit out? Do you want it to spit out, oh, I have a zero bank balance, or have acne all over my face? Or do you want it to spit out that your SP freaking hates you and blocks you and finds somebody else? Do you want it to produce that denial letter? Do you want that, or do you want it to produce the shit that you want? Obviously you want what you want, right? So when you look at something and instead of relaying the message of what it looks like to your eyes, you're gonna relay the message that you want it to produce. You're not gonna give it the paper that says, hell no, we don't want you. You're gonna give it the paper that says, oh my God, congratulations, you are our top pick. oh my God, I'm so freaking in love with you. I literally will do anything to be with you. Please marry me. Please, you're the love of my life. Or you're gonna give it your six-figure bank account to produce. You're only going to feed your subconscious things that you want it to produce. That is what wavering is. When you know that your subconscious doesn't have eyes, but instead you're confirming the shit in the 3D that you don't like to your subconscious so that it can keep producing it or hold that one in place, that's wavering. Don't do that. When you know you're in full control of what this thing produces, because you're the messenger, you're the one who relays the damn message of what you want in your reality and what you want to experience, you can literally, it's like Photoshop. You are the Photoshop. You're the Photoshop. So you can change the picture that you see by saying something different to your subconscious, by thinking something different when you see it, no matter what you're looking at. Say something else. Say something else. It's the same thing with revision on the spot. Say you get a text message, like you literally get a text message from your SP, and they're like, ew, stop talking to me. I've never liked you. You are going to tell your subconscious that that text message just said, I'm literally obsessed with you. Please be with me. Please be with me. He's literally begging you right now. He is begging you. You saw him at a bar, or you saw her at a bar and they were with somebody else. No, they were literally following you around all night, begging you to be with them. You and your SP broke up, or you and your spouse got divorced, or your spouse wants a divorce. No, they're literally begging you. They're begging you to take them back, or they're begging you to renew your vows, or whatever. What? Ever. I'm just coming up with shit off the top of my head. Okay? You decide. You are the Photoshop. You are the editor. So when you see something in the 3D you don't like, you don't go, oh my God, this is so terrible. This always happens to me. Look at my zero bank balance. They freaking hate me. Look, I got denied. Poor me, victim mentality. You don't do that. You do not do that because you're the fucking editor. You are the newspaper editor, and you are not gonna send that shitty paper through to the press to be printed, are you? I wouldn't. I mean, that's embarrassing. Have you seen Gilmore Girls? Do you think for a second Rory would approve a zero bank balance? Or not a love story? Or for God's sake, a college denial letter? No. She would never approve that. It would never go in the paper. It would never go in the Yale Daily News. Okay? So, editor, I need you to edit it before you send it here. Okay? I need you to edit it before you send it here. No, that's what I mean by no wavering. Edit to what you want it to be, and then send it here for after you've approved it. Send it here, and then here is going to put it out in your reality if you'll stick to the story. If you'll stick to the story that you edited, your subconscious printer is going to give it to you. It's going to produce it. That is the law. That is how it works. If you will persist, and I don't mean persist as in like, okay, like I affirmed. Where is it? How long is this gonna take? Why isn't this happening? That's still wavering. You're still sending a message. You're always sending a message here. So what message are you sending? Are you sending, it's not here yet, it's taking forever, is this gonna happen? Because then you're producing the experience of, where is it? Is this gonna happen? You're gonna keep producing waiting and experiencing it not happening because that is what the message you're sending. What message are you sending your subconscious on a daily basis? You that will literally tell me, I'm doing everything right. I'm not wavering. What message are you sending your printer on a daily basis? And I mean even when you're not affirming, like when you're not doing your affirming sessions or whatever you want to call them, when you're not consciously affirming, what message are you sending your printer? Because that's how you need to think of your subconscious. That is your 3D printer. What message are you sending it? What paper are you giving it? What you typing? That's what I want to know. Because if you'll really think about that, think about your subconscious as a 3D printer, and then think what message you've been sending it. Because all messages are valid. All the papers you submit are going through, especially when you're doing them all the time, or especially when you're reconfirming something you already believe or are already experiencing. Every time you reconfirm the unwanted experience, you're holding it there. It's just gonna keep producing it. It's gonna keep printing the same experience over and over and over and over again. When are you gonna change the copy? You have to change it at some point. When are you gonna edit it so it can produce something new for you? Because if it's not producing something new for you, then you're clearly not doing everything right. Y'all love to say you're doing everything right. There's no way you are if you're still, after a good period of time, if you're still experiencing the same thing with zero change, then somewhere you're still reconfirming the old message. And so it's still printing it. Because if you're doing repetition, now here's the thing. It's very easy to identify a problem when someone says, I have been affirming for 10 minutes every single day. 10 minutes? I'm not saying you have to affirm your life away, but 10 minutes in a 24-hour day? What are you doing for all the other minutes? What are you thinking? What are you doing? What are you sending your printer? Because if you're only for 10 minutes out of your entire day, that's the only time you're sending your printer that message. Well, it works the rest of the day too. So what are you sending it? Because it's gonna produce more of the thing it's most receiving. That's just common sense. This is why I say it's your dominant thoughts that manifest. It's your dominant ones, the ones that you're constantly repeating. And then after experiencing them, then it's just going to be what you assume. And usually after you've created an assumption from experiencing it, that's when it's just gonna naturally be there because it's already what you expect and assume. But currently, if you're just doing 10 minutes a day, out of all those other minutes, what are you sending it all those other minutes? Because if you're complaining or whining or wondering where it's at, how long is it gonna take? Why is it taking so long? Or even completely just complaining about the subject at hand or having a pity party in your mind, whatever it is, outside of those 10 minutes, that's just not enough. It's going to produce what you're feeding it the most. So that's what I want you to do. I want you to think of your subconscious from now on as a 3D printer. I want you to look at that 3D, and if you don't like what's in it, you don't need to go digging for nothing. You don't need to be looking for no blocks. You don't need to figure out why. My thing with figuring out why is it like this, it's very simple. There's nothing to dig up or search for. It's because that's what you've been feeding it. That's the message you've given it to print. That's it. That's all you need to know. Who gives a fuck? You don't need a deeper meaning. Just understand, like, okay, I don't like this, so edit it. By editing it, I mean come up with an affirmation that implies you are actually having the experience that you want. You're going to affirm that experience in your mind so then you can experience that experience in your reality. That's what I mean by being delusional. It might sound... Actually, I don't care how it sounds. Be delusional. That's what you have to do. You have to look at the 3D. If you don't like what it is, if you don't like what you're experiencing it, you need to edit it, send it to the printer, and let it produce something else. But that's the only way. That's the only way. It can only produce what you feed it. It cannot give you something just because you desire it. You have to live the experience in your head for it to then produce it out in your reality. Doesn't matter what teacher you listen to, Neville Goddard, Joseph Murphy, whoever, they're all gonna tell you the same damn thing. You have to live the experience here before you can live it in your 3D. So that's what you're doing by affirming. Okay? Edit your 3D and send it over to the printer. Send the new copy to the printer. Okay? Don't send shit through if you haven't approved it. If it's not something you want to experience, don't send it to the printer. Okay? Thank you so much for watching. Please be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And